Can cloud computing be used for something else than storing your files or sharing your pictures abroad? Of course. Here I'm going to show you some applications, some ideas, some of my research, but of course, it's just a little example of what can it be done with the cloud computing. The first example I'm going to show you is about meteorological forecasting. What brings us here is a collaboration I had with the Spanish Meteorological Agency. So they were working on a provision of the 24-hour weather forecast for all the citizens of Spain. And they were looking for an optimal and sustainable solution. So instead of buying supercomputing only for this task, what we were proposing was to use cloud computing, and in particular that provided by Amazon. If you remember, Amazon is about a pay-as-you-go provision. You are only paying for what you use. Our solution allowed to have this 24-hour forecast in only 1 hour and a half and only paying for $60. And of course, this was less than buying and maintaining a supercomputing for this. If our cloud solution was about using 128 processors, if you wanted to buy this, it was about $200,000 in HP. Another example I'm going to give you of real life problems that can be solved using cloud computing is a collaboration that I'm having with the University National of Cuyo, which is a region from Argentina. This region of Argentina represents the 70% of the national vineyard. And frosts are their worst enemy. Well, here in Russia, of course, you are used to frosts, but in Argentina, they have a very big problem with them in agriculture. Think about that in 2013, 80% of the production was lost. And this drove to a very big economical problem, for not only for the region, but also for the country. They are very keen on mitigating the effects of frost when the frosts are being detected. They have different elements, they have different methods, and they are very good. But the problem is when you want to predict the appearance of frosts. And this is when computer science gets into action. So in this collaboration, we provided a two-part solution. In the first hand, what we have is low-cost weather stations that were handed to farmers. They were like small boxes with different sensors that they were sending all the data in real time. And they were meant to last for about 2 years, 3 years, depends on the battery. And what we were asking to the farmers was, okay, you just put as many boxes as you can and all spread the field. But then, what we do with all this quantitative data, this big data that we were receiving, we need to process it somewhere. So what we were doing here was to execute several algorithms for this prediction of the appearance of frosts, based on the data that was arriving from the different sensors. So for a typical example of 10 hectares, we were providing a solution that would cost only 2 cents per hour. And this can be considered, of course, a sustainable solution for a well-known problem. So besides the different real-life applications, real-life problems that can be solved with cloud computing, there is a main area that benefits of cloud computing. For me, is the most important, even more important than research, which is teaching. You know, as assistant tenure track professor in a university, what we conduct is a double life, like superheroes. We teach during the day and we research during the night. And research and teaching benefits one from each other. And as teachers, we have a big responsibility with the next generation. We will fill the ranks of science. And I'm actively using cloud computing for this. In particular, when I'm advising final year projects. So I can give you some examples of cool things that can be done in one academic year. So for instance, one project from one of my students was putting together images that were being streamed by different webcams in places such as airports, train stations, and this application he was developing was extracting all the faces from the webcam images and then crossing them with databases that could be from Interpol, FBI, or police from different countries. So this way, you could do a real instant monitoring of criminals in certain public places, considering the unfortunate events that we are facing nowadays. And of course, this needed a high computing resources. So he was using cloud computing for providing them. Another example was a group of students that they wanted to provide a way for mobile application developers to store data on specific places, geolocated places. Something like what we are doing now, I mean our society, with Pokemon Go. But they wanted to do it in a general way. This was years before Pokemon Go, of course. So just let's give you an example. You are the owner of different shops in Moscow, and you want your clients to have an application on the mobile phone. And when your clients approach a specific shop and you have a discount on a specific item, you want to make them alert of this. So their application was providing all the basis for a developer to store information. We were using this solution of these students for my hometown, which is El Escorial, because last year we were doing a historical gincana. We were celebrating 200 years of the proclamation of the liberation of our hometown in the hands, from the hands of the French. And what we did was this historical gincana where players were traveling from one side to the other side of the town and they were looking for specific places. How did they know that they were in the right place? Because the geolocation application of these students that was stored entirely on the cloud for guaranteeing high availability was telling them so. And the next clue was only loaded when the right place was visited. Let me say that here we were also collaborating with Ubisoft, the video game developer. So we were using Assassin's Creed theme for our historical gincana. Another project that was done by a group of students of mine was an extension of the subject of the course I'm teaching right now at Complutense University of Madrid. Basically, I'm teaching computer network security. In other words, I'm teaching my students to be hackers. And how do I teach my students to be hackers? Well, a lot of laboratory work is done. So we were working with virtual machines. The idea of this project was to deploy different scenarios, different cyber war scenarios for each player and make some way for handling the score of each player to see how they were able to break a given machine or bypass a specific firewall. And all of them was maintained by a computing cloud. In particular, this project was of interest of the Spanish Defense Ministry, and in particular from the Cyber Command unit we have there. Another example was from another student who was deploying secure teleconferencing systems on the cloud. Here, security and in particular privacy was vital, especially when you want, for instance, go to a specific country and you are fighting for freedom of speech or any of human rights. So the idea here is that you want to talk with other people from other side of the planet, and the different elements for this teleconferencing system are being deployed basically on the fly. And they are destroyed when the conference is finished. This way, you can reuse all the elements, and this way, all of these cannot be traced at least easily. Last but not least, another project from my students was about to deploy a personal Tor network. But of course, the problem of a current Tor network is that you don't know which elements are participating, and some of them could be tapped. So here they were using cloud computing for deploying on the fly their own Tor networks, which would be used only by them. This way, cloud computing was contributing to their security and their privacy. So, I hope you enjoyed the different examples I have provided. They were more regarding industry, more regarding international cooperation, and they were also about student projects that could be accomplished in one academic year. As you see, cloud computing is not only everywhere, but we can do very cool things with this technology.